Hello everyone, this is SAP Garut. At this time, I'm going to explain the concept of a business partner in S4 HANA. As we know that in S4 HANA, the business partner is the single point of entry to create the customer as well as the vendor. We can't create the customer or vendor through the normal traditional ECCT call for the customer as well as the vendor. Everything has to be go through the business partner master data creation. So then, what is the usage of the business partner in S4 HANA? What is the relationship between business partner number versus the customer or vendor number? And then what is the benefit of a business partner, like the multiple address and so on in S4 HANA? This is something that I'm trying to explain in this video. I will try to create a couple of video to explain about this business partner in S4 HANA. Let's see on the screen. The three code to maintain business partner in S4 HANA is pretty simple. We just need to type BP in the screen. So then you will get this initial screen. The next step, for example, we just want to create a business partner as organization. So you just click this button, organization, then you will get this initial screen. So if you notice that this initial screen basically is almost similar with the customer or vendor initial screen. We need to maintain the name, the address, the postal code, language, and so on. On the top level, if you see, there are two very important field in S4 HANA business partner, which is the BP role and BP grouping. What is the BP role? The concept of the BP role, in the simple word, it is like account grouping in ECC customer or vendor master. In the BP role, we can configure which field that we need to activate in this screen, which field that we need to set as mandatory in the tab of the name of the address on the postal code, or which field that we want to hide. So that is the main concept for the BP role. Usually for the BP role, we don't create the new BP role, we're just using the standard SAP BP role. For example, because we want to create the business partner for the customer master, then we just need to choose the BP role VLCU01. So if we click the BP role VLCU01, by default system will pop up another screen, which is there will be a new tab, sellers and distribution. And then if you see the name, there is suddenly the field, the first name is mandatory and so on. So that is the main purpose of the BP role, to set up which field need to be as mandatory, which field need to be as optional, as well as which tab that need to be activated for this BP role. The second field that important is the BP grouping. The main purpose of the BP grouping mostly for the numbering logic. So through the BP grouping, we can set up what is the numbering for the business partner. It could be as internal numbering as well as the external numbering. And the most important thing, through the BP grouping, we can synchronize between the business partner number versus the customer number or vendor number. As I mentioned before, that business partner is the single point of entry for the customer or vendor creation, meaning that once we go into this BP screen, we maintain everything, the data here, and then we save the data here, then system will generate basically two numbers. The first number is the business partner number. The second number is the customer number or vendor number, depend on the BP role. So that is basically the very basic concept of the business partner. So let's try we maintain all of data here. Let's say the BP name is just typing based on his previous history. Alright, Just fill in the very basic information. So if I save this screen, then system will generate the business partner number, which is this number. And then if we go to the tab, there is a one tab, we call it customer general data. If we click this one, then the system will assign this number. So basically with one transaction, we generate two number. One is the business partner number and the second one is the customer number. We might end up having two different number, or we synchronize everything with the same number. It depends on the business process. There is no right or wrong to set up the number. But mostly if the project is the new implementation project, fresh implementation, we synchronize the number between business partner and customer number to simplify the process. But if it is upgrade, sometimes is we use the customer number same with the ECC number, but the business partner is the another number. So that is the very basic concept of how to create the business partner in S4 HANA. I will create another video how to configure, especially to synchronize the number between business partner and customer number, in another video. Thank you very much. See you in another video.